Welcome back to RG Geek. Today I've got a special video for you. I just got in the brand new Game & Watch Super Mario Bros. Color Screen. I'm super excited to open this for you guys, so I'll just do a quick unboxing. I haven't looked at it yet, as you see it's still sealed. Let's get inside here. So, see, nice little screen captures there, Super Mario Brothers, Super Mario Brothers 2, or as it's known in the West, the Lost Levels, Ball, the very first Game & Watch game, and The Time. The Time looks like a very exciting game. So this is the German edition. Let's see if it can focus there. So with German and Dutch description. All right. So let's get into this. Ooh. There we go. What comes in the box? And for fun, I've got the OG Super Mario Brothers Game & Watch. You've seen some other videos on my channel about this. You can see other Let's Play videos of that. But let's get into this one now. So I see a cable. It's a USB-C. A manual. That looks pretty similar to the original manual from what I remember. Health and safety regulation. Information. Alright. It's big. It's big. Espanol. Netherlands. Okay, nice. Got all the languages covered here. But nothing too interesting, I have to say. Let's keep going. Let's throw that away over there. Yeah. Really looking forward to is the game. Nothing else in there. Nice. Oh, it's shiny. Nice and gold. So you can see how it holds up to the original here. The exact same size. On the side, we've got a USB-C port, power. Nothing on top. That's USB-C. Maybe that's not USB-C. I'm not sure now. Look at that later. On the back. Typical safety information. All right, let's turn this on and see if it has battery already in it. If it comes on. Yeah, nice ball. Press time button. All right. That's cute. See, this is a set button. Oh, the controls feel great. So is this the tradition on my unboxing videos, I set the time, which everyone finds exhilarating. It's 46, which is funny because it doesn't connect to the internet from what I understand. There we go. We have game. Nice. So you can pick which game you want to play. Let's go with the original Mario Brothers. One player. Nice. This is cool. Well, it feels weird in this small D-pad and buttons. It works though, it's very playable. It's hard to get used to though. Grab this one up. Alright. So if I pick game, I can go to the other ones. Let's try the Super Mario Bros. 2 or the Lost Levels. I've only played the Super Nintendo version of this, really, so this is nice. And obviously it's hard to play while looking through the lens here. And hit that poisonous mushroom there. Yep. Nice. This is fun. It's a bit hard to control because you're used to a bigger controller these days. But it's so cool. Man. And I haven't actually played the other game. That's the original Game & Watch game called Ball. I love these generic names you have. Game A and Game B, alright. Like the original Atari 2600, you have games like, it's just called like tennis, football, combat, super simple games. So here you have to juggle balls, and they get faster as you play. I think there's, yeah, two positions there. This is history right here. I wish there'd come more games, but it's already cool for what it is. Neat. Look back in time. So, speaking of time, let's look at that real quick. I hear there's some like Easter eggs in here or something. Nice. This is a really neat clock. Oh, the pause button. All right, set the volume and the brightness. Which is funny because on this machine, you couldn't even mute it. You had to just play it with sound on. See the old game and the new game. So I'm not sure what else to say. I haven't looked into this too much, but I'm gonna be checking this out. I'll probably do a I want to do a review later on, so if you want to learn more about this, subscribe to my channel. If you like this, please like it, and I'll see you next time.